guys, this is going to be a first for me of trying to do a video on screen, and I imagine I'm probably going to be doing lots of stammering because this is weird just talking to my computer. First of all, let's go ahead and go through this, and I'm going to try and do a mosaic using brother and sister here. So these are going to be the two images that I am going to be working with. There, got a little bit of time to get them back in focus. I have gone both of these and already put them in black and white. So what I'm going to do is, just so you can see what I've done, I'm going to go back to the regular full color, and just so you can see how what I've done. Have not made any adjustments here. It's already looking quite good there. One thing that I did do on this is that if you'll take a look here, I'm going to click on this and add. So what I had done is I had brought out the exposure on her so that it did not increase the exposure on the background, because what happens if I do that is if I increase the exposure by, say, one and a third stops, you're able to see the wrinkles in the cloth in the background, which we don't want. So if we keep that all the way at zero, but just do an adjustment tool to where only this area we increase the exposure, it keeps us from bringing up all of the wrinkles in the background here. So anyway, so that was something that I did with a lot of these files, just to be able to help out the image itself, keeping that background where how I want it to be. Excuse me. For converting these over into black and white, once you've got the exposure the way you like them, click on this for grayscale, convert to grayscale. Generally, on many of these, the orange gets to be down here like this, which is just fine. She still looks absolutely wonderful here. On different complexions, it just doesn't look right. So what I've done on this is just brought it up a little bit just to be able to give some extra contrast. I'll be honest, everybody, I messed up. I should have shot all of you guys with a white background. Reason being is that with a white background, all of your mosaics would have shown up in all of this area. So, unfortunately, I messed up. I did this on a black background because the last time I was up at Victory shooting some portraits, I was already in that mode that of having already been shooting black. It was my mistake. But in the end, I think this is actually going to turn out really interesting, and I'll show you some samples of the way that we can play with this and make it kind of cool looking. Be able to work with it, but we might have some ways of doing an inverse where you can still see something over here, or maybe we leave it so that you don't see it, just stays black, but the mosaic will only show up on the portrait itself here. So we'll get to that and play with a couple of options. So I've done the same thing with this image of increasing the exposure on him itself, but leaving the background as is. And then also with the conversion to grayscale, I increased the orange to help out his complexion, and it works out with here. I'm just going to take this down here, and this looks wonderful here. It's really going with where you want. You can get to where it can be too dark only because it's against the black. You want to have enough that we are going to be able to see some contrast. Later we can play, just play with your own files on that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open these up. The pictures that I had saved before and sent you all were, to keep them smaller, were 13.5 megapixels. I'm going to go ahead and take that resized fit off so it's in the default, the original 42 megapixel size. This is so this is working off of the raw files that you have as well. So we're going to go ahead and just open these up and start playing with them. As those start to open, this is a project that I'm currently working on with Operation Aware of Oklahoma, and it was kind of a neat deal that we did that in your, I recorded this in the dark room there at the school, but this is basically a long exposure of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, all distilled into one image. And as it's still trying to open the second image, I'll just go ahead and, my problem was me, not, let's see. So I need to go back here. Oh, and I remember that it was file 7094. I was trying to open it in a different software. Let me get her open. What happens? I forgot to select both of the images before opening. And what I think what I'm going to do, ladies first. This is just a very strong image and just looks very great. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this as our main image here, as our top image. And then what we want to do is we're going to figure out what we want to do to make a mosaic of this. Pulling our calculator right over here, I want to do this of to what? I'm going to create, go here, we're going to do a new canvas. We got to, how big is our canvas going to be? We need to have 16 times, for a 16 by 24, 16 by 300 pixels is going to be, where'd it go? Going to be 4,800 wide, or I should say 4,800 tall, and 24 inches times 300 dots per inch is going to give us 7,200 wide. So width 7,200, resolution 300 pixels or dots per inch. And create this as our new. This is the canvas size that we're going to work this to. Now what I can do on this is can crop this down. One, if you want to just make it, instead of doing the math to drop it down, you want 24 wide times, 16 tall. Bam, we're right here at the right aspect ratio, okay? Just to have double checked. The other thing, no need to crop it because that was just to be able to show that we are at the right image. If we were going to be going to, if you were going to be doing it the smaller size, and this was 16 wide times 12, you can see how the two 16 by 12s is going to need to crop the image down a little bit. I think I want to go ahead and just maintain it at the regular 24 by 16 or a 2 by 3 ratio. No big deal. Alright, let me get back off of that. So I can do a command A to select all of this. Then what I want to do is image size. Let's go to that same thing of 7200 times by 4801. 4800 is really what I was trying to be able to get to. That's just fine. I'm going to make this smaller so that this, I'm going to do another command A to select everything. Then command C is going to copy that. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to paste it. Command V. And this is what happens when my computer is like a 2010 and it is about time for me to get a new iMac. It is running slower than it used to. Okay, so here's where we're getting started off. Start with our background over here to be able to see that this is resized to our 16 by 24, our first layer right here of her, of the hole. Now, what we're going to want to do is we need to figure out what we want to do for the image here. With this, I want to go down to image size, and as far as height, this is 5,300 pixels tall. That's way too big. We're going to want this fairly small, but since we are using the larger 16 by 24 print, we're going to make this 100 pixels tall. 100 by 150. Tiny. Command plus is going to increase this in size. That's 100% view. We want to make this bigger so we can see what it is we're working with here. Now, because this is all black, here's what I foresee a problem. All of this black, when we put up right here, is going to make this all too dark. So I think the way that we're going to need to do this is we're going to invert the colors and see what happens with this. Actually, tell you what, I'm going to do step backwards. Like that's not going to work right now. That's fine. This is the size that we're going to be working with it being tiny, tiny. So, going to select all, Command A, image, let's see, select, filter. It should end up being, I'm going to just try something going off of Command I. Yes, Command I is invert. That inverts all of the colors. So with this being all black and white, this made everything black, white, and so forth. So this wasn't exactly what I was first thinking of, but this is going to be a way for us to be able to have a mosaic where this is going to be what bleeds through on the image. So now that I have this, it's already selected all around, so I'm going to hit Command C, go over to our new Untitled, and for right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click that, deselect that, so you can no longer see it. I'm going to zoom in. And let's go all the way up to the top corner. I'm going to do a Command V and move that into place. Okay. I'm going to do another Command V, put it up in place. Here's where I had mentioned in class that it's good to zoom in far enough so that you can really see where things are. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch this around right now. The background, I'm going to paint it black just so I'll be able to tell if there's even one line of black that's going to show. So I'm going. So I switched to my top color is black. I'm going to go to my paint bucket. I've selected that on my background. I'm going to fill my background to color it black. Okay. So the useful thing on this is that now I've clicked on it, and I'm going to use my arrows to move it over, just even just one little bit. So even if it's over just a little bit, you are going to see that there is a white space. This will just help you get it lined up properly as it needs to be. And if you're zoomed in further like this, as you hit Command V, it's going to go over closer to where it needs to be at. And you don't have to move the tiles over quite as far. And at this point is where each time that I'm pasting another one, you'll notice it's creating another layer. And realistically, I probably didn't need to do this. I probably didn't need to do this, but what's going to happen is that we're going to be able to test this out a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click this and drag it to the top. That means whatever is on the top is visible here. And it looks like I accidentally moved that image. So let's see what happens. As you're going to be able to see, I somehow moved the picture down and to the right because you can see a little bit of this border. So what should start to happen in a second is that right up here we should see me right there. I'm just starting to cover it up. Boom, covered it up all the way right there. Now let's go over to the end, and from right here is where I'd cover it up. Let's pull that so you can see where the corner is. I'm going to bring it right back to where it was supposed to be. All right, I'm going to hit Command minus. I'm just reducing it down. So you can see over here, this is our viewing size down to 50% scale. We'll go smaller. Ah, I did it again. Okay. Let's get this centered and bring it. Okay, there she's centered. Okay, what's going to happen is if I do this fill, some degree, it's a matter of how much does that mosaic show through. At 80%, you can see that in the background there. 90%, you can see that there. So with this, this might be a cool effect. We can play with this a bit, but it is going to be worth to go ahead and do our full set. What we're going to do is going to do 10 across and 10 down. From there, or you know, if you want to do 5, maybe we just, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, might as well go 10, and then 10. That way we'll have our block of 100. We'll compress this down and redo it and keep doing blocks of 100, 100, 100, 100. And that's going to be the fastest way to be able to get through these manually. So I'm going to go ahead and bring her back down there so that we can see these on top of it most. And I'm going to go back up. I'm going to command plus, plus, plus. And move this over. And go back to more. Command V's. Let's get these popped in here. Anybody have some good tunes to be able to play while we're doing this boring part? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. From here, it's just a matter of filling all of this in. The nice thing is that this is kind of locking the edges. Once it gets close, it is snapping into place. I bet if I were to play some kind of tunes while we were doing this, I'd probably be violating some kind of copyright or something. Oh well. I'll just keep this up. So again, the reason that I'm doing this is so that it's mostly a white, and so that the part that is shining through here is just a bit more faint, a little more subtle. Trying to have something of an almost black image, a mosaic of that trying to show up on another black image. There's just not enough contrast, and that's where, as I said, I messed up on, should have shot everybody on a white background, but I'm kind of digging this inversion of, this really looks like a film negative. I mean, they're called a negative because it's a negative of the colors, complete opposite, and then it's processed from there. So this is, it's one of those things where sometimes doing things, you get surprised by mistakes and will lead you down to a path of something really interesting. I remember one of the first pictures I took with my digital camera that I had totally messed up the white balance, and I was taking some photos around Tulsa, and had this picture of the Golden Driller. Went to the Golden Driller and I was taking some pictures. The white balance, I had, instead of been on auto, I had it manually set to something just really crazy. But in the end, it was very cool because it turned it into turquoise sky instead of being just a light blue sky. And it just looked like some kind of pop art that I had done, and it was all by accident in the camera. Oops. I accidentally hit Command B, which was going to adjust color balance. Definitely don't need that. So each time, really, you don't even have to try to find where the square is, because each time it's starting into another layer. If you look over here, I'm on layer number 70. And so anywhere I click, it's only grabbing that top layer. It just helps the closer I am to it. Oops, and I just messed up there. See, I got a little bit ahead of myself. So I need to find, here's one way of finding it. Let's see, where is this one? Oh, and just deselect and select again until you can find where that one was. Layer 65. So, layer 65, I'm going to click on it so that once I move it down here, we're good. So 72. After a while, these start to all just kind of run together. All right, I'm going to zoom in a little bit. It might help out with getting it where we want to. And I imagine, hopefully, during this part of the video, you are fast-forwarding this until I get done, because it's kind of silly to watch me continue and do this part of it. Now, you could say it's good to go ahead and keep some kind of system of go all the way across every time. Sometimes that can be great. Sometimes I just get a little distracted and just want to change things up a little bit on this monotony. And I'm at the point that I'm far enough down, I just want to start finishing off and start working with the smaller section. And do what you want. As long as things are lining up proper, you're not going to need to go back and search for something. In case you see that something is misaligned, you're going to need to do that of coming over here and clicking on each one until you find exactly where the layer is that you got off, and go from there. So far, though, it looks like we're doing great. All right. So let's see. I'm going to do another new image that is the same, 7200 wide by, was 4800 high. Create that one over there. Okay. So on this, I can cut down the canvas size. And let's just go ahead and go pixels. We're talking in the specifics here. We're 150 wide. times 10, so that's 1,500 wide. And height is 100 times 10, so that's 1,000 pixels tall. I started in this top corner, so I want to do, I want only this part of it. This is going to crop it down. Yes, the canvas size is smaller. I am clipping it down to just the square that we've put 100 mosaics. Oops. Let's do undo canvas size. Canvas size. Pixels, 1,500, 1,000. I must have accidentally hit 100, not 1,000. It's going to go smaller. And this is going to cut out a whole lot, and it's going to leave us just with our block of 100 mosaics. It's having to, you see, once you've got 101 layers, it takes a lot for the computer to work with that much information. And so that's something where if you were to put one layer at a time all the way across your entire piece, you would just have way too much information. You would definitely bog down all the computers. Now from here, since we've got this, looks good, what I'm going to do is go to layers, and we're going to flatten the image. What that's going to do is that's going to convert all of these, instead of being 101 different layers, it's going to go into one layer. So this way, we can now do a command A, select, we've now selected everything. Now I'm going to do the same thing of to copy, do a command C. That copied up. I'm going to go to the new background. I'm going to do this again. Same thing of our background. Let's make it black so that we're able to see what, see where we're at. Okay, fill that. Now I'm going to hit Command V to paste. Command V, bam. That put us our first block of mosaics. I'm going to put it, snap it right up to the top. And you see just how fast this is going. Definitely worth taking that time. And what's going to happen is this isn't going to be a full 100 over here. It's not going to fit in just perfect. So what I want to do is go ahead and get all of the rest and do this right side last. Yeah, it's hard to see where it is. Good thing it just moves all on its own, right? Okay. All right. Now we are at a point where we need to zoom in. I'll come across down here, and I'll start at the bottom and go across. Go. Next one, snap into place. I'm doing well. All right, now I'm going to go to the top. down. Pop into place. Scroll down. We're almost there. Bam. All right. Command minus. And there we have all of these. Now this is in 25 layers here. So now what we can do, we can come back and take this image. It's already been a select all. And we can do a command C to copy. And come back to this new image, command V, and paste that on top. From here, actually, tell you what, I'm going to delete this. Go right, I'm going to delete this layer. Let's start that over. Let's start that we've got this. What I'd like to do is take this layer and merge it down. Flatten it. Boom. That's taken our background into just this one image here. Now, let's paste this. I'll just make processing a little bit easier with this. From here, see, the interesting thing with this is that if you lighten it up too much, you start to see the wrinkles in the back. Really interesting. So what I might need to do on this is once I start to see this, I'm going to click on this layer. And let's see, should be to burn. Let's see how much this works. Burn is going to darken things. I've got this on midtones. So what's happening here is I'm trying to darken those parts of the fabric background that I didn't want to be seeing all of the wrinkles. Back in the day, in the actual darkroom, your main things for adjusting exposure was dodging and burning. Dodging is being able to bring out extra detail, lightening something. So dodging is lightening, burning is darkening. So, good now. Took care of that. So let's go back here. So at what point, where are we that we can feel like she's still strong, but can we see him at all? This might be a little bit too strong. So it's 76. I'm going to play with it a little bit. And on some of this, maybe it gets to be that we see it more on the background than we do on her. So this is at 50%. I'm going to go ahead and change this to 100% viewing size. So if you were to look up close, being on the background, you would be able to see the mosaic. then on the skin, you actually don't see it all that much. You can tell something is still there, but it's definitely more faint. I actually kind of like this look. Now, on some of this, it might be a matter of, do I need to burn a little bit more? Burn in on our hair just a little bit more. But I think that's got a good look to it. One thing that could also have been done on the original image in RAW is that I could go back knowing that the background was going to get brought out a bit more, is that's a easy place to be able to, just like I did the brush to lighten the face but and body but not the background. You can also then go on another brush, and even though it looked completely dark, I could make it even blacker by decreasing the exposure on all of the background. It just wasn't until putting this mosaic on it that I realized that it was even something of possibly needed. So once we have this, we can save it as whatever file that you desire. Thank you, and I hope this was helpful.